Hello everyone, welcome to this talk. I'm Seonghyun, PhD student at Korea University. I'm so glad to talk in CHESS. In this talk, I'm going to present you our paper, Novel Key Recovery Attack on Secure ECDSA Implementation by Exploiting Collision Between Unknown Entries. This work was joint with Sanghyeop at NIMS and Seongmin at CIUT. Let's start by explaining backgrounds. ECDSA is a representative digital signature scheme based on elliptic curve cryptography. Since digital signature has an important role in providing authentication mechanism, it is used in a wide variety of security services. ECDSA has strengths in speed and memory compared to RSA. Thus, it is preferred to be used in constrained environments such as smart cards. On one hand, size channel analysis is known as a practical means to break a crypto system. Although such crypto system is designed to be secure theoretically, it causes size channel leakage such as power consumption, electromagnetic emission, and timing when the crypto system is executed in a real environment. Since such leakage occurs depending on a secret, attacker can recover the secret by using the leakages. Thus, it is well known that crypto system must be implemented securely against size channel analysis. However, the signature implementation might not be trivial. Also, it is needed hard work constantly because a novel attack might be appear such as this presentation. Next, I will show the overview of ECDSA sign algorithm and side channel analysis against it. Let me explain ECDSA sign algorithm first. The following is a brief version of ECDSA sign algorithm. First, ephemeral key or nonce K is chosen randomly. Second, scalar multiplication KP is computed. Then, signature is computed through long integer calculations. In this procedure, scalar multiplication and long integer calculation treat secret key D and nonce K. If these operations are implemented naively, then it works depending on the secret values and it is reflected in leakages such as power, EM, or timing. Side channel attacker can recover secret from such leakages. I will present a few of side channel analysis against the ECDSA sign generation as overview. Side channel analysis is divided into single trace attack and multiple trace attack depending on the required number of traces. Let's first show single trace attack. SPA is a simplest side channel attack. Here is a power consumption trace of scalar multiplication as a representative example of SPA. Since this trace has two distinguishable patterns representing point doubling and point addition, attacker can identify secret immediately by identifying such patterns. To counteracting SPA, scalar multiplication can be implemented by performing regular operations like this, using double and add arrays algorithm, or using only unified point addition. However, advanced single trace attack, collision attack, can recover even protected by such countermeasure. There are several collision attacks, but here I will introduce only HCCA and Rosetta. Scalar multiplication has two core operations, which are point doubling and point addition. These point operations are based on finite field arithmetics. Also, each finite field arithmetic is implemented based on long integer arithmetics. Thus, single point operation can be separated into multiple word arithmetics. HCCA and Rosetta exploit the collision characteristic between base arithmetic of target point operation. Attacker can know whether collision occurs or not by comparing two sets of word arithmetics of target long integer operation. With this characteristic, the attacker can discriminate secret scalar. On the other hand, the other kind of side channel analysis is the multiple trace attack. This class of attack uses statistical method for finding secret. Like SPA in single trace attack, DPA and CPA are representative multiple trace attack using difference of means and correlation as a distinguisher respectively. So-called HMP, hidden number problem, is the other representative multiple trace attack. If the attacker can get partial information from scalar multiplication or long integer operation, such partial information can be converted into the closest vector problem related to secret key. Then, the attacker can solve using solver algorithm of lattice problem, such as LLL lattice basis reduction or Babbage's nearest plane algorithm. In this talk, our attack is a new multiple trace attack, but use the collision technique for subtrace clustering. Regular table-based scalar multiplication is our target algorithm, so I will introduce more detailed. Regular means that scalar multiplication perform an identical sequence of point operation independent to scalar. One hand, table-based scalar multiplication is widely employed when it computes over a fixed point like ECDSA signing. It handles some scalar bits chunkwisely at a time, not a single bit. Thus, it is well known that it is efficient. Fixed-based CUM, NAP windowing, TSM are the example of table-based scalar multiplication. Regular table-based scalar multiplication can provide no perfect security, but give practical security against the side channel analysis. In next slide, I will show how table-based scalar multiplication is working. Table-based scalar multiplication consists of two processes. Each process is algorithm 2 and algorithm 3 respectively. First procedure is a preparation of pre-computation table. The pre-computation table is computed according to a specific scalar multiplication algorithm. Each entry is a consequence of scalar multiplication on corresponding specific scalar. Second procedure is a scalar multiplication using the table. First, index sequence Ks is computed for input k. This sequence consists of row index, which of entry for referencing entry in the table for loop. In the main loop, two operation is computed. Appropriate doubling is first computed according to function WS, and an entry in a column corresponding to the loop is loaded and accumulated according to the index sequence KS. I will explain how scalar multiplication is work by example. Let's assume index sequence K is given according to inputted scalar K. Each component of Ks represents a row index of each column for referencing table entry. Like this, each entry is accumulated according to Ks per each loop. This procedure can be also presented as a expression as follows. And expanding this expression, we get a linear expression of entries. In here, W is a doubling related term and T is a chunk of scalar related term. This can be interpreted as each entry reference has an effect same weight. Now I will explain a novel key recovery attack. This attack requires two assumptions. first assumption is that WS is a function of index J. Simply speaking, doubling operation depends on your loop index. The second assumption is that side channel attacker can get sufficient trace on multiple ECDSA signing with a fixed private key and pre-computation table. This can be considered as a common sense in view of multiple trace attack scenario. With these two assumptions, our attack can recover secret key by exploiting only collision characteristic between unknown entry referencing. In this slide, I will explain concept of our attack. When multiple ECDSA signature generations are performed, attacker can collect trace on scalar multiplication. Each trace occurs during this below expression is computed. Trace include leakage on each entry referencing. We use this leakage. With visual inspection or some size channel analysis technique, attacker can extract subtrace related to each loop or referencing table entry. Then, on two subtrace corresponding to the same loop, in other words, on vertical subtrace, the attacker can distinguish whether the two vertical subtrace is on referencing the same entry or not by collision attack. This can be possible although there is no information on the table entries. For all vertical subtrace on each loop, attacker can group and label it by pairwise collision attack. Let's name the label sequence as collision information. On one hand, ECDSA signature expression can be converted like this. Note that attacker don't know information unknowns. However, if two collision information has same group label in same index, this means each nonce has the same table entry as your component having same weight. In short, collision information is a relation information between nonce. Thus, if attacker can find the linear dependency of nonce only exploiting this collision information, attacker can recover secret key D. Next slide, I will how attacker can find the linear dependency. For the convenience of explaining, we consider a 3x3 pre-computation table as an example. Attacker has no information on the pre-computation table, but by means of side channel analysis, the attacker can easily guess secret parameter like the size of the table. Aforementioned, each trace includes leakage on table entry referencing. Attacker can cluster subtrace vertically and get collision information. Each collision information presents how nonce are related. Attacker don't know real value of entry and row index from collision information. However, attacker's goal is to find linear dependence of nonce only using this collision information for recovering secret key. Thus, with this setting, I will how to find the linear dependency in next slide. Attacker has no information on the relation between different group labels. Thus, we consider each group as to be independent. For that, convert vertical group label in one hot representation. Since the pre-computation table has three rows, a label is converted into three-dimension one hot representation. So, in this case, collision information is transformed 9-dimensional vector and call it converted vector. Then, the value of converted vector means that how many corresponding entries in the table is used for constructing nonce. However, attacker don't know how each component of converted vector map the table, but know whether same entry is included between nonce or not with this converted vector. At this time, if there is converted vectors only one more than the dimension of vector space, There must exist a linear dependence of the vectors, and the attacker can find the linear dependence by Gaussian elimination. Then, linear dependence of converted vectors is equal to linear dependence of nonce. Therefore, attacker can know a linear dependence of nonce resulting zero. Finally, from this, attacker can recover secret key by simple algebra. Furthermore, if attacker find the basis of converted vector space, then all table entries will be found but without index information. As I have mentioned many times, this attack can be possible even when there is no information on entries, by only exploiting collision between side channel leakage. But in current, there are some limitations. For finding linear dependency, collision information must have no error. If error occurs, attacker cannot find the meaningful linear dependency. Thus, if error can be possible, current only solution is doing trial and error process with a sufficient pool of traces until success. However, clustering error can be possible due to signal-to-noise ratio. I will show the probability of error is significantly low in ideal environment. The ideal environment means that signal-to-noise ratio, SNR, is so higher that side channel leakage clustering algorithm is working well. So, set the leakage property. Let's consider leakage is a loading entry of a pre-computation table. Then, the entry is the coordinate of a point kp. Since the coordinate of kp are determined by scalar k, for convenience of explaining, let's assume loading an entry in table is just loading scalar 32 bit word wisely. Also, let's assume Hamming weight model. Then the target leakage consists of 8 points. In this setting, error occurs when different points have the same Hamming weight leakage. Thus, we confuse the probability. First, the probability of 2 Hamming weight of the two different words being equal is the below. Then, when two different entries are chosen, the probability of two leakage being equal is the below. This probability is quietly low. Thus, if SNR is sufficient, then our attack must success. Next, I will show our attack is simply applied to fixed base CUM and TSM as case studies. First case study is on fixed-base CUM scalar multiplication. It is a representative table-based scalar multiplication. For the sake of simplicity, we consider original version of fixed-base CUM method. Fixed-base CUM algorithm is not in here. Please refer to paper for the algorithm. Fixed-base CUM scalar multiplication performs only one-point doubling for loop. Thus, WS is a constant function output only 2. And since fixed base CUM using the same table during the main loop, let's consider the original table as a single column in our setting. Then, this can be interpreted as our attack straightforwardly. Then, according to the security parameter of fixed base CUM method, we can compute other parameters, especially the dimension of converted vector. Thus, from this, we can determine how many traces are sufficient to succeed our attack necessarily. Second case is TSM scalar multiplication. This algorithm is designed only for counteracting single trace attack. With different to general scalar multiplication, TSM have output K and KP. In other words, TSM cannot compute KV over inputted K. Thus, TSM has a limited employment, such as ECDSA signature generation. Unlike the fixed-base CUM, TSM is not familiar to you. So I gave scalar multiplication algorithm. TSM used two pre-computation tables of scalar and point. Each entry in scalar table is randomly chosen, and each entry in point table is computed according to corresponding entry in scalar table. TSM scalar multiplication chose row randomly and accumulate corresponding row entry in main loop. This work with our target algorithm samely. Thus, our attack can be applied easily. From TSM scalar multiplication algorithm, we know TSM have no doubling operation in main loop. Thus, we set WS and table size the follows. Then, as in the previous case, according to the security parameter, we can compute the dimension of converted vector and we can determine how many traces are sufficient to succeed our attack necessarily. Finally, I will show experimental result as a proof of work. We experimented on 256-bit TSM scalar multiplication having 4x128 free computation table. With the practical view, we implemented first accumulation of scalar and point just by loading it. And in remain loops, we implemented to perform long integer addition and point addition for accumulation. On Chibispero STM target microcontroller, we collect only 513 power consumption trace on TSM scalar multiplication. According to our attack complexity, it is sufficient to succeed attack. This is a total power consumption trace for TSM scalar multiplication. Attacker can guess security parameter easily by simple means of side channel analysis, such as visual inspection or cross correlation. Then, the attacker can identify and extract all target subtrace from the total trace. We describe a detailed process on paper. Please refer to our paper for it. For prevailing collision information, we first find interest points on load leakage using variance trace. In each quadrant, upper plot show real group labels and bottom plot show variance trace. Gray box indicate selected interesting points for load leakage. Left upper part is about loading scalar and point in the first loop. In this case, load leakage is clearly presented on variance trace. The remaining part is about subtrace corresponding to last loop operation. Right upper part is about subtrace for scalar accumulation. Two bottom parts are about subtrace for each coordinate when point accumulation is performed. With different to first loop, load leakage is not clearly presented on variance trace in all three parts. But because load operation is performed priorly, attacker can guess it with some trials. We had succeeded clustering with no error using this load leakage. I skipped the clustering algorithm in here, but in our paper, we provided correlation-based clustering algorithm for four classes. And this clustering algorithm work well in our case. Please refer to our paper for detail again. Therefore, we finally had found secret key through our attack. Thank you for listening. If you have any question, feel free to send me email. Thank you.